Yes. Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. I was busy programming. In fact, I have been for most of my life. Not busy, but programming. I discovered computers in my early teens, way back in the 80s. And back then you had to program to use the computer. The user interface was the programming language. So at the very least, you had to type in commands to load and run your games and other programs. My friends and I quickly learned that we could look inside the programs. There was a command to list an entire program, and then we could edit the code, mostly to include our own names in the credit screen and pretend that we had written the entire things ourselves. But we gradually figured out what other parts of the code meant, like print and input, if and for, and so on. And I guess we learned something about programming. In fact, it was kind of hard to avoid learning about programming back then. Almost every computer magazine that you could buy would have listings of small programs that you could type into your machine, whether you understood them or not. And since the programming language was the user interface to the computer, the manual it came with was also a programming course. So I, like most of my generation, first learned programming by reading the user's guide. Furthermore, I read practically every book on programming I could find at my local library because I really wanted to learn everything about it. But it was somehow never enough. I mean, I quickly learned the elements of the language, how to print something to the screen, how to read input from the keyboard, how to use variables, if statements, for loops, subroutines, and so on. But that was just writing code. I wanted to learn how to create programs. How would I go about combining all those elements into writing my own game? And how could I design and create my own unique program? How could I go from an idea to a fully functional program? I was always looking for the book that would help me do that. The book that would take me one step further. That would teach me how to use what I already knew and combine it into something original. But they all started from scratch, explaining what a string was, how to add two numbers, how to draw to the screen, and so on. I had done that. I knew how to write code. I could follow a recipe. I wanted to learn how to create my own recipes. I wanted to understand how to go from "I want the enemy spaceships to attack the player in a spiral pattern" to code the necessary variables, arrays, if statements, for loops, and so on to do just that. I never found that book, even though I continued my search while studying programming at college and throughout my professional career as a programmer. By all means, I read a lot of books on application development, software design, object-oriented analysis and design, requirement analysis, software construction, and so on. But they all seemed to take the approach that you already knew how to create software. Now you just needed to learn how to do it better, to do it professionally. And to be honest, a lot of them seem to merely move program construction from writing code on the computer into drawing shapes on paper. You were still expected to simply know how to connect the parts into a working application. Well, after years of searching in vain, I kind of learned it anyway. And I guess that if you make a living writing programs, then you gradually get the experience needed to create those programs. You'll build your own personal library, maybe just in the back of your mind, of various well-known problems and their solutions. And if you're really experienced, then you might also get some ideas on how to work on new and unknown problems. For years, I actually tried writing my own book, but I always fell into the trap of writing yet another introduction to programming, rather than the next level programming 2.0 I wanted. And apparently I'm not alone. Because even in later years where video tutorials have more or less replaced books, they still follow the same pattern of having a chapter about variables, a chapter about operators, a chapter about control structures, maybe a chapter about if statements and another about loops. And each chapter then contains everything that could ever be to know about that subject for that programming language. Then I guess you're expected to read the entire book, often closing in on 1,000 pages, commit it all to memory. And now that you know everything there is to know about the language, you can start programming. Kind of like you would read the entire dictionary before beginning to write a story. Except that you wouldn't. because that's not how learning works. Whether it be language, arts, sports, science, math, history, or indeed programming, you usually start with some sort of limited experience. You learn to speak the names of things around you. You learn to use a coloring pen or a painted brush. You learn to count, and then you use that knowledge. You utilize it in your daily life, use it to solve problems and learn more about how it can also be used, situations where it can't be used, variations that work better or worse, and you expand your knowledge depth-wise in learning more about that specific things and width-wise in learning about other things connected to it. But you never, or at least rarely, gain complete knowledge of every aspect. Take the dictionary as an example. If I were to go through the pages and highlight every single word I knew the definition of, I would leave a lot of blank spaces, but probably also a lot of filled-in islands where groups of words are all well known to me. And if you were to do the same, you would probably end up with a completely different, but still similar result. Spotty or blotchy with blank areas, filled in islands, and the odd lone word here and there. And of course, a lot of the words would be marked for both of us, otherwise we wouldn't be able to understand each other. But even when we do know the same words, the order and the circumstances in which we learned them were probably very, very different. I know that I learn much better when I have a need. If I'm working on a project and got stuck on some problem, then I'm highly motivated to learn how to solve that particular problem. Maybe even to learn a bit more about that kind of problems in general. So I expand my knowledge both depth and width-wise. And this new knowledge will build upon, or at least be connected to, the knowledge that I've already applied working on the project, thus making it much easier to remember the next time I have a somewhat similar problem. If knowledge are islands in a vast sea, like the highlighted words in the dictionary, learning something during a project builds bridges between those islands, making them connected and reachable, much easier to read than those lone islands in the middle of nowhere that are rarely visited, never built upon, and easily forgotten. And I guess that's what they're trying to do, the books and videos that teach programming. They want to help us build this network of connected islands. Because in programming, almost everything is connected to everything else. The problem is that the route is set for you. And even if you're working alongside tutorials, doing actual work and feeling accomplished, it is a bit like driving on the motorway. You'll quickly get to where you're going, the trip is easy, smooth driving at a constant speed, hardly any problems, at most a bit of congestion or a break for charging. But you haven't really experienced anything. And when all is said and done, you quickly forget most of the trip, as you quickly forget most of what you did in the tutorial. This is what is sometimes referred to as tutorial hell, or what I think is a more fitting term, tutorial purgatory. Where you go through one tutorial, want to apply what you have learned to your own project idea, but have no idea where to start. So you watch another tutorial, you want to apply that knowledge as well, but you still don't know what to do. So you watch yet another tutorial, and so on and on it goes. But don't blame the tutorials. This isn't a new thing, not at all. Back in 1999, in the first edition of Extreme Programming Explained, Ken Beck wrote about his experiences from the 1970s. I remember when I first learned to program. I had a couple of workbooks covering the fundamentals of programming. I went through them pretty quickly. When I had done that, I wanted to tackle a more challenging problem than the little exercises in the books. I decided I would write a Star Trek game, kind of like one I had played earlier, but cooler. My process for writing the programs to solve the workbook exercises had been to stare at the problem for a few minutes, type in the code to solve it, then deal with whatever problems arose. So I sat confidently down to write my game. Nothing came. I had no idea how to write an application bigger than 20 lines. So I stepped away and tried to write down the whole program on paper before typing it in. I got 3 lines written before I got stuck again. I needed to do something beyond programming, but I didn't know what else to do. And that is what I want to do with this channel. Offer this something beyond programming, this next level to the fundamentals, textbook exercises or tutorials. Basically, programming 2.0. I call it 2.0 because it is your next level of programming. Not a replacement for learning code, not a new way of doing things, but the next level you should ascend to when you have done all you can at the entry level. You learned about variables, if statements, loops, probably a bit about functions, arrays, and maybe even objects. And now you want to do more than write code. You want to create programs. Because learning works so much better when doing projects, I want to do everything I can to encourage you to do your own projects. I will spend a lot of time on how to plan your project, how to decide what to build, how to understand it, and how to get started, and how to continue when you don't know everything up front, and how to structure everything in order to be as successful as possible. And I'll be doing a lot of my own projects, where you can kind of follow along, experience how the various principles are applied, and then hopefully get inspiration to do your own projects in a similar way. Learning will always be spotty and blotchy, with a few islands of knowledge spread around the vast sea of all available information, some islands connected, some visited all the time, and some forgotten. And this channel will be equally spotty, not with large series of long connected courses or tutorials, but with videos about a single topic. Sometimes just giving an introduction, sometimes diving deeper into a specific part of that topic, and sometimes adding a bit of width to the general knowledge. I invite you to watch videos, maybe not entirely at random, but select the topics that interest you right now, and then follow the connections to learn deeper or wider, whether you're interested in one or the other. That's why I'm not writing a book. There can never be a perfect order in which to learn all this stuff. Most of the videos will be about program design, how you plan and structure programming, how you connect the things you've already learned to build larger programs. Demonstrate with example projects where I gradually apply more and more learning. But I will also take some deep dives into what would be considered the basics of programming, stuff you probably already know, like variables, loops, and functions. But I want to talk more about what lies beneath the surface, the principles and philosophies of the code you are already used to write. And because I find programming a fascinating subject, and I think that one ought to be interested in one's craft, I will also look into what I call the philosophy of programming, and talk a bit about the history of programming, try to understand what programming is in relation to other fields, discuss how much math is actually needed, and look into how we grow and learn as programmers. I'll probably add more categories as the channel grows, but as of yet, I just want to teach you how to ascend from writing code to creating programs. So, welcome to Programming 2.0. If this is your first visit to the channel, then I recommend watching The Perfect Programming Process. But grab a beverage first, it's a long one. It's this one right here.